Hello guys, you are welcome to today's training. Today we are going to be discussing on how to record employee salary without deduction or addition. So we are just going plainly on the basic for now. So I'm going to create another video that will include additions like bonuses, subtraction like taxes, loan, etc. So now, first of all, you have to go have an employee. So if you click on employee menu, click on employee center to see the list of employees that you have. So currently I have three, so I'm going to add additional one so as to show us how to create employee. So go to new employee here. So we're not going to insert much details just for the training. So can you put Mr. Abdulrahman Yakubu. Okay. I think this should be okay. These are just the information I need. There are other things, but I just want to create salary. So click on OK. Now we have four employees. I want to pay these employees their salary for the month of November 2022. So now we are going straight to creating the salary. So how do you do that? Let's go to chart of accounts and come to company. Under company, you go to chart of account or click on Control A. Now this is chart of account. From our bank account here, we can see we have 338,000. Okay. We need to create two accounts. So we'll be using payroll expenses and payroll liability. I'm going to tell us what those are. So the payroll expenses is under expense. So if you go to expense, you see we have payroll expenses. This is what we're going to be using. Similarly, we are going to be using payroll liability. So if you check up other current, we have payroll liability. So for this first step, we are going to make use of majorly these two accounts to record our transaction. Now we are using journal entry, so go to company, go to make general journal entries. Okay, now this should be the first 0001. So today's date is 4th, so we are paying them let's say on the 30th of November. Now this is using the simple double entry system in accounting. So we are going to debit the payroll expense. You can type in payroll to bring out these payroll expenses. Then we are doing this for the four employees. So let's start with 10,000 for employee number one. Then the second credit is going to be payroll liability. Now payroll expenses is the expenses we are supposed to pay as regards their salary. Now the liability means we are just recording it for now, then we are going to now pay them through our bank account. So there are sometimes, it's not all time that, for record purpose, it's not all time that some employee pay on time. Some employer, they don't pay on time sometimes. So definitely you need to know how much you are owing your employees at the end of the month, even before paying. So this is important that you do this before paying, so you know how much you are owing your employees. Whichever way, you can still even if you are paying them instantly, you still need to create this payroll liability. So now this is for the first staff, so we'll repeat the same for the remaining. So let's say the second person is 20,000. Okay, so payroll liability. So that's the essence of the liability, because we are not paying instantly. Then we need to track this payment so that we can now, whenever we are ready to pay, we just go to the liability and pay instantly. Why the period expenses is for our income, profit or loss statement. It has to be there. Okay, so we'll go to payroll expenses again for the third person. This time another is 30,000. Okay, then also select payroll liability. Okay, now the fourth person also payroll. Now you might be thinking of, are you going to be doing this all every time, every month? With QuickBooks, you can easily memorize this transaction. Then once it is time to pay December salary, you just go to list and go to memorize transaction list. You select from there, then you create a copy and enter a transaction. It's as easy as that. So you don't have to, except you need to make an adjustment. That is when you can still adjust the memorized copy also. So payroll liability, good. So we have this for four persons. So a memo is going to be salary for the month of November 2022. Okay, so we can have this copied. Copied. So copy this. So Control V. So if you are memorizing this transaction also, once you have created a copy, I want to make use of it. Definitely, you still need to change this to December, since you want to pay them for December. So the name of the person that is responsible for the first. So we have Abdul Fatah Munir. We also select Abdul Fatah Munir. That is the first one. The second one is Abdurrahman Yakub. We also select the next for Abdurrahman. That's the double entry. The next person here is George Christ Mode. We also select George Christ Mode. The next person here is Yaya Salifu Yaya. So we also have Salifu Yaya. Okay, now you can see it's 100,000. So the total is 100,000. So one interesting thing about QuickBooks is that it automatically arrange your ledger for you, your double entry. So once you post to the right place, it will link everything together. So now we are done for the first step. So we've not paid, but we want to keep record of the expenses, accrued expenses. You can still call it accrued expenses because they've worked for the last November already, and we're in December. So whichever terminology you think is best for you, you can make use of. So let's save our name, close. So why am I closing that? I want us to review the report. So now I want to show us what we just did now. So let's go to the report, company and financial profit and loss, and standard. So we'll see the expenses of 100,000. Now the date is 30th of November, so we're going to select 30th of November only, because that is the period we are covering here. So we refresh. So now you've refreshed, you've seen payroll expenses under profit and loss has 100,000. So you might want to know what this 100,000 is made of. You double click on that. So once you double click, you see we have 10,000, 20, 30. You can see Abdurrahman, Abdurrahman Yakubu, Abdul Fatah, George Christ Mode, and Salifu. Yeah, yeah. 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000. This is the cumulative balance. Now, this is just the profit or loss. And definitely, you can sort them you can arrange them by employee so that you see. For individual employee, for Abdul Fatah Munir is 10,000, Abdurrahman Yakub 10,000, and like that. So if you want to now see the liability, because you've not paid them, so you also go to company and financial, then you go to balance sheet standard. So once you are there, let's go directly to payroll liability. See, it's 100,000. It means we've not paid them their salary. You can also double click that, so that we can see the analysis. You can see we already have them here, Abdul Fatah. So we are holding these persons. Then you can also arrange them based on employee, so that you classify them. Now you can see we are still holding this person. So now let's go back to our company and make general journal and make payments to these employees. So on that same 38, this is the second version. So we are going to now select the debit side. Now is going to now be payroll liability, because we want to pay that liability. So individually, in our lesson here, we are dealing with the staff individually. So you can also have the gross total. You can have the total of the salary if you want to, whichever method you want to make use of. Okay, this first person is 10,000. Now this money is coming out from the bank, so from First Bank of Nigeria. The next one here is also still payroll liability, which is 20,000, and it's also coming out from First Bank, our bank account. So the next is 30,000. Okay, 30,000. This payroll liability. Okay, so we are going to do that for the remaining. So here is First Bank. Okay, now the next one also is still payroll liability. Now remember, the first time we credited the account and now want to debit it. So liability account have credit balances, so if it's going to the opposite side, it means we are reducing it. Similarly, asset account has debit balances, so if it's going to the credit side, it means we are also reducing it. You can see First Bank here is an asset account, but we are crediting, it means we are reducing from our First Bank to the payroll liability. Okay, so that's just another class, the basic of accounting. Okay, First Bank of Nigeria. Okay, now you can see it's 100. Now for this, I'm going to now use payment, because I'm paying directly now, payment for salary, payment of salary for the month of November. So here now 2022, you can see now I'm paying them, so I have to record it as payment. So copy, paste. Okay, now I'm going to select the person that is here. This one is Abdul Fatai Munir. This is still Abdul Fatai Munir. Okay, this is Abdurrahman Yakub. This is also Abdurrahman Yakub, the double entry. This is George. Okay, you can click the first initial, the initial of the George. Then this is payroll liability. Okay, and then this is Salifu. Okay, now we have this. So I want us to do something. Let's say we'd not pay Sally for the complete salary, we paid him 35,000. So you're still gonna see how this is going to take effect at 5,000. Okay, now you see it's running 5,000. So let's just go away with this. Okay, we are done with this, so we'll save and close. Okay, now you can see, let's go back so that we can click on open windows. Okay, let's exit this also. I want us to actually go and check the report. We'll still get back to this place anyway, but let's use, you can click on escape. On your keyboard. Okay, now let's go to report. So we'll go to company and financial, then we'll click on profit and loss. So now the date again is 30th, okay, 30th of November. Now refresh. Okay, now payroll expenses is still that 100,000. Nothing has happened because our second transaction did not involve the payroll expenses, so this is good. Now where we should be interested on is our balance sheet. Okay, Now we've clicked on balance sheet. Now let's go to other current liability. You see our payroll liability here is 5,000. Remember, I would not pay Sally for Yaya, his full salary. We only paid him 35,000. So but let's double click to see how the transaction is. Okay, these are the transaction. Let's bring them out well. Okay. Now you see for Abdul Fatah Munir, 10,000 is out, 20 out, 30 out, but for Sally for Yaya, we are still owing Sally for Yaya 5,000. So this is how to make payment. So now you can see from this liability, payroll liability, we can see get to know how much we are still owing the employee, or if we are not owing the employee at all. So I hope this class is educative enough for you to understand how to record salary, employee salary. So this method is making use of salary without addition or subtraction. So my next video is going to be on addition and subtraction, should in case there is deduction for lateness, or there's deduction for payee, or any other penalty, or there's an addition for compensation, bonuses and the likes. So I think that should handle that. See you guys in the next class, and bye.